Hey all, welcome back to the Firewater Cooking Channel. I'm Darren, of course, and today I'm just gonna do some St. Louis style ribs on the Weber Smokefire EX4. I've done low and slow on it with the brisket. I've done some hot and fast searing. I've cooked some chicken on there, but now we're gonna do some ribs and see how this Smokefire handles one of the simplest meats you can barbecue. I'll be right back.
Smoking, grilling, getting hot and hotter, sous vide and chilling from Fire and Water.
Okay, well, this is going to be a simple cook, guys. Like I said, I got some St. Louis style spare ribs here that I got from my local grocery store. They probably do have the membrane on the back, so I'm not going to bore you showing you how to take that off. It's really simple with a paper towel and a knife. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to season them up with some of the Meat Church rubs here. I'm going to use the Holy Voodoo and the Honey Hog Barbecue. So I got a little bit of sweet, a little bit of heat. Mix those up, see how they're going to turn out. So I'm going to use the Weber Smokefire, and I haven't done ribs on this yet. And one of the things with ribs is, you know, there's really many different ways you can cook ribs, but you know, people have the pit barrel type barrel cookers that they love to use. They cook them usually hotter. I think the pit barrel runs that are like around 275 to 300 degrees on a normal thing, and they hang them on hooks. The Smokefire, since it is more of a direct type heat, where it does have the open kind of open flame kind of on the bottom, I'm thinking it's going to cook these very similar to what a pit barrel or any kind of drum type smoker would cook them. So that's what we're going to do with these. We're going to put them on the Smokefire. We're going to cook them probably right around 275 or so. I think we're going to do them with the smoke boost function probably for a good 45 minutes. Then we're going to crank up the heat to like 275. And let them run till they're done. So that's it, guys. Let me get these out of the pack, get the membrane pulled off, get them seasoned up, and we'll get them on the Smokefire. I'll be back. All right, guys, I'm back. Took the membrane off the back of the ribs here. So I don't put any kind of binder on my ribs or any of my barbecue meats. Matter of fact, I don't put mustard on, I don't put Worcestershire sauce. You can do any of that stuff you want. You can put apple juice. I just use water. So I got these ready to go. I'm gonna go ahead and put the Holy Voodoo on first and just get a nice, good, even coat of this on. All right, guys, well, I'm getting this rub on, a nice even coat of both rubs on both sides. I'm letting the smoke fire get up on the smoke boost function. So about 15 minutes or so, and we'll be putting these on.
That's it, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and do the other rub, the honey hog, and do the same thing. And I'll be back when we're done doing that. Then we'll put them on the Weber. All right, guys, it's been about 15 minutes or so since I've had this Weber smoke fire on the smoke boost. You can see got a good amount of smoke coming out of it. So I'm gonna go ahead, put my ribs on. Like I said, we're gonna have this on smoke mode, on smoke boost, which is right around 180 degrees. So that's what we got going on here. About 45 minutes or so on the smoke boost. Then we're gonna go ahead and crank the heat up to about 275 and let them just run. We're not doing any kind of 3-2-1 method or anything like that, or 2-2-1. We're just gonna let them run. I may sauce them at the end, I may not. I usually don't sauce my ribs. I let people choose the sauce they want at the end. So you guys can do whatever you want. I'm not gonna sauce these today. We're just gonna let these cook till they get nice and tender. So, all right, guys, I'll be back when we're gonna switch this temperature up. All right, guys, it's been about 40 minutes, just right at 40 minutes. And as you can see, I don't know if you can see, I'll get a little closer in there. They're starting to turn color there, so they're looking pretty good. So I think we got enough smoke flavor on there with that high smoke boost. Do you see that smoke's rolling out of there? So I'm gonna go ahead and crank the heat up. I'm not gonna bother doing it on the app. I'm just gonna do it right here.
because it's pretty easy to do. And I'm going to crank this up, like I said, right around, I think I'm going to do 285. And we'll let these go. The way I'm going to check for tenderness is I'm just going to use my instant read and kind of probe in between the bones to see how well the thermometer goes into the meat. So the old-fashioned way. All right, guys, we'll see you back in a few when these start getting cooked. I may flip them because the fact that these Weber smoke fires kind of have like a semi-open fire pit, I might flip them over or move them up to the next level so they don't get too cooked on the bottom. So I'll check them in about an hour and a half to see how they're doing. See you in a little bit. All right, guys, it's been a little over an hour, 20 minutes or so, and it's been up at 285 here for at least an hour and 10. So I want you to look at those. Look, the color's looking pretty good. I'm gonna go ahead and spritz these with some water. Just to get some moisture on there to attract some more smoke. And then I'm gonna go ahead and put these on the top rack, I think, for a little while. Just because I don't want them to get overly burnt on the undercarriage here. You can see how they're looking there. So they're looking kind of dark on the bottom side. Just because I said this grill, it's more open than most other pellet grills. So you're getting a lot more direct heat. It's not just indirect heat, it's direct heat there. So we're gonna see how these do on the top rack on the flipped on the other side for a little while. So I'll come back in about another hour and see how tender these are getting. I'll be back, guys. Well, all right, guys, it's been right about another hour or so. I'm gonna go ahead and see how these are looking. They're looking pretty good on this side for sure. These are pretty meaty for St. Louis. I'll get you a close up of that so you can kind of see how those are looking. Looking pretty good to me. The bones are starting to pull back pretty good. I'll flip them back over. The fat's rendering pretty good. Push this back. So they're looking pretty good. Nice color to them. I'm not going to probe them yet because I know they still got a little bit of ways to go. But that meat pulling back from the bone is telling me that they're getting where they need to be. So I'll probably give it another 20 minutes or so, and then I'm going to probe them, see how they're doing. They're almost ready. So, all right, guys, I'll be back. All right, guys, it's been another 30 or 40 minutes or so. And I moved my this smaller rack up top again because it was a lot less meaty and it looks like it was cooking a lot quicker. And I probed this earlier and it was already sitting at like 203, so, and it's sitting right there right now still like 202, and it's probing really, really tender. And I let this one stay down here closer to the fire, and we're in the 199 range, 198. So I think we're good on this one because this has got some thicker parts here, but we're still pretty good, most of it. So I'm going to go ahead and take both of these off and get you a quick look on here. I mean, they look really, really good. I mean, the color on these bowls are awesome. So we're going to get them off. I'll put them on the pan. I'll see you over there while we're cutting them up. All right, guys, these look awesome. I'm gonna go ahead and put one of my gloves on so that I don't burn my hand. Like I said, I like these gloves because as long as it's not 500 degrees, it won't melt my fingers. So, all right, guys, so I got my two racks here. Like I said, they probed really, really good. The color on these is phenomenal. Just wanna kinda show you the color, the holy cow, or the Honey Hog Barbecue and the Holy Voodoo actually did a really good job on this. So I'm going to go ahead there. See, they're pulling apart right here on this one. I'm going to go ahead and cut one of these right off so I can show it to you. Take a bite. Look at that. These are pretty much fall off the bone, but take a look at that, boy. Nice smoke ring. Nice and moist. Smells like it got plenty of smoke as well. Look at that. Bite right through, no chew. Mm-mm. Good stuff, guys. So the Weber smoke fire, those ribs, perfect. Like I said, I didn't have any doubts about that, just because I know what the barrel type cookers do. But check it out, guys, the Weber smoke fire. As far as I can tell, it can do pretty much everything they claim. It can grill, it can smoke, it can sear, it can do everything. So check it out. Thanks for watching. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram. Check out the Fire and Water Cooking page, the Fire and Water Cooking groups, and I'll see you again on the next Fire and Water Cooking video. Thanks, guys.